Meantime, today in West Sacramento, derailing diesel and driving innovation, Sierra Northern Railway unveiled the nation's first four-axle hydrogen fuel, zero-emission locomotive. Fox 40's Juliet Smith was there as leaders celebrated this milestone. She joins us now live with those details. Juliet.
Nikki, it was proudly designed and tested and built right here in the heart of West Sacramento. Now, officials hope that this locomotive could set a new standard for the rail industry as the push for clean energy picks up speed. State and local officials celebrated the nation's first hydrogen-fueled zero-emission locomotive in West Sacramento. This locomotive is leading the charge without a drop of gas and putting the brakes on emissions. The mayor of West Sacramento says it's a big day for the community.
It's just going to provide all the way around a healthier community and also, you know, helping with our local economy.
The Sierra Northern Railway CEO says it will replace 10,000 gallons of diesel every year.
The diesel locomotives have been the main operation since about 1945. So this is the first real transition.
Officials say the Golden State's 260 switcher locomotives consume an average of 50,000 gallons of diesel each per year. Converting them to hydrogen power could cut more than 12 million gallons of diesel usage each year, the equivalent of taking 20,000 cars off the road.
This thing will run for 80 to 100 hours before it needs to be refueled. And compare that to like a battery operated locomotive that needs to be recharged every day on 4 to 8 hours. Operationally, that's very significant.
Officials say it's not just a prototype. It's a model for the future of freight.
When we do something here in California, the rest of the nation looks and follows. And what the United States and what we're able to do here can be followed around the world cost effectively.
Sacramento City Council member and California Air Resources Board member Eric Guerra was also on hand today and says we should continue to offer more opportunities without compromising the health of those living near rail yards, many of whom are from historically underserved communities.
You know, all of us remember those smoky days with particulates, the emissions, the smog. The fact that we've been able to reduce our smog levels because of working with industry is improving the public health for us here. We need to make sure that our kids have a long, healthy life while growing our economy.
And now they are building three more, and officials hope to have all four track and ready by 2027. For now, reporting live in West Sacramento, covering local news that matters. Juliet Smith, Fox 40 News.